I will talk to you straight from my heart without any preparations. One of the finest TED speakers has been a man called Shah Rukh Khan. Let me use this opportunity to pay a tribute to his talk and be the prequel. Because this is a man I know intimately, and I think that it's a story that's inspirational. I am the Dean of the School of Contemporary Media of Pearl Academy today. But over the last 40 years, I've been an actor, a producer, a director, a writer, and a whole bunch of other things. I multitask. One of the earliest films I made was a film called Patthar Ke Phool, in which I launched a lady called Raveena Tandon, you must have heard of her, with a man called Salman Khan. And we were shooting on a very busy road in Bombay called Linking Road. And that's the place where you can only shoot on Sunday afternoons because it's a holiday. And the assistants came to me and said, sir, go sit in a coffee shop because you're creating a whole bunch of confusion here. These actors are new. You work on television. It's creating crowds. So I went and sat in a little coffee shop called the Bandra International Coffee Shop. And there was this other man sitting there. I didn't know who he was. The waiter comes and says, sir, he's Shah Rukh Khan. You know, he's in one 4G serial. He's a big star. He wants to borrow a cigarette from you. I was carrying a pack of cigarettes and I gave a cigarette, and then he came for a second, and then he came for a third, and finally I think Shah Rukh came himself and apologized. I said, no, sit down. We started talking. I said, are you hungry? He said, yes. I said, let's have some akuri. He said, what's that? I said, it's Parsi scrambled eggs, you'll enjoy. He had two plates. Shooting got over, it was about 6:30. The assistants came, packed up, went back. We'll meet in the office the next day. I said, goodbye, let's go. He said, where are you going? So I said, I'm a movie buff. I watch movies. For me, every school is a cinema and every textbook is a film. So he said, but where are you going? I said, there's a cinema called Sterling that has installed a system called Dolby Sound. And there's a James Cameron film playing there. So I'm going to watch that. He said, I'll come with you. I said, come. We got into my father's old beat up Fiat. We went to the Sterling. It was full. So I bought tickets in black. Shah Rukh wanted to eat popcorn, so we bought popcorn. We sat down and we watched the film, 3.5 hours. It got over, then I said bye again. So he looks at me and says, can I borrow 100 rupees from you? I've got to go back to Bandra. Now this was the day before internet, smartphones, credit cards. You just carried a few 100 rupees, it was more than enough. And I was the one who'd been spending all day. So I didn't have the money with me. I had spent it. So I said, okay, no problem, get into the car, we'll drive back to Bandra. In those days, there wasn't that much traffic. But there was no gas in the car. So I said, all right, what we'll do is we'll go back home. My mother normally has insomnia, she'll be awake. She'll give you some money. Mom was asleep that night. So I said, all right, I'll have a shower, I'll give you a pair of shorts, and you can stay the night. He stayed 2 years. And he was very clear that he did not want to act in films. Very clear. So I said, why don't you want to act in films? He said, I have a girlfriend called Gauri in Delhi. And TV is okay, but no films. I said, but there must be a reason. He says, in film you have to hug girls. I'm not allowed to. So I can't do films. I'll do TV. So every time he went back to Delhi for a few days, he'd come back, he'd stay in my house. He was very happy with me, my parents. And then one day, I knew his mother was sick, but she died. I went to Delhi, I came back. Few days after his mother's funeral, he landed up in Delhi, in Bombay at about 5 in the morning, and he rang the bell. Normally he used to call and I used to go to the airport and pick him up, but he actually rang the bell without telling me. And he was there with big bags this time because I think there was no reason to go back to Delhi anymore. And he said, will you launch me in films? I said, yes, I will come in. He said, no, you have to swear right now. Otherwise, I won't come in your house. Drama, but still. I said, okay, I swear. He says, no, you have to be serious. You have to actually do it. So I said, come in. We will sit and we will do it. He didn't come in. He kept his bags inside. And he said, let's go down to the coffee shop. I lived next to the Taj And they had a coffee shop downstairs, which was a 24-hour coffee shop. And let's write the script. So I went to the coffee shop and we wrote Raju Ban Gaya Gentleman together. And then I went out in the market. And for a man who was so popular on television, nobody was interested in the film. They said, Vivek, you're very new. You've made a film called Patthar Ke Phool, which is a hit. You should make another film with Salman and you should make another film with Raveena. Why are you making a film with this man? I said, but he's very good. They said, yeah, but you know, he's a TV star. I said, yes, but that means he's hugely popular. So the first thing that struck me, and this is where my education in cinema started, was what the distributors want, what the producers want, may not necessarily be what you want. What the audiences want may not necessarily be what we make. Now that is for me a paradox. It is a dichotomy. And 90% of us who fail in life, and I'm using cinema only as an example for life, is because of this dichotomy. What we need to do, what we think we should do, what we expect to do, and what our customers, our audiences, the world, society expects us to do. But how I cracked the code, was actually by sitting down in old cinemas and talking to projectionists, ushers, and very old people, people who'd been in the industry for years. And there was this very old man, he's dead now. He said, Vivek, sit down, let me tell you a story. And the story that he told me changed my life, and obviously because I taught it to Shah Rukh, it changed his life as well. He said, early on in India, when we got independence and before, we were and are a poor country. Agriculture was the important things. Industry was burgeoning. Everyone was busy creating things except film. We didn't take that seriously. That was not a priority. And yet there were filmmakers in those days. Satyajit Ray, Raj Kapoor, Guru Dutt, Vijay Anand, Manoj Kumar, B.R. Chopra, all of them wanted to make movies. But they had to make films with borrowed money. I said, yeah, that's a fact. And that borrowed money was cash. Because the taxation in those days was so huge that nobody had money in the bank. Everybody had money under their beds. I said, yeah, so? He said, so you go to the money lender, you borrow money, you make films with borrowed money, and then you pay the money lender back when the film is a hit. What happens if the film is a flop? You run away. And that money lender cannot go to court and cannot go anywhere because it was cash in the first place. So all the money lenders got together and they said, let's figure out a deal where our money, cash though it is safe. So they went to the lab. The lab was the place where the negative that we shot on was processed and stored. And they said, we have an agreement with this particular producer. And until he doesn't pay me back, he cannot release the film. The implication is that the film had to recover the money that was spent on it and the interest before the first ticket was sold. Which meant that the producer was making a film which had to recover money without anyone going into the cinema. How illogical is that? So the producers got together and they divided India into five zones. There was the northern zone, which was Delhi, UP, Punjab. There was the eastern zone, Assam, Orissa, Bihar, Nepal. There was the central zone, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. There was the western zone, India, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Saurashtra, North Karnataka, Goa. And then of course there was the south, Andhra, Tamil, Kerala, Karnataka, five zones. And they appointed distributors and said, pay us and buy the film for that zone. And then you put it in the cinema. And when you pay us before the release, we'll pay back the financing. Effectively, the producer had only five customers. He didn't care if a sixth person didn't see the film. He wasn't making films for the audiences. He was making films for those people. Those people went to the cinemas and they sold them attractive posters and said, how nice this is. This is the star. See the poster? Buy my movie. And those people, the theater owners, were buying the movie to play it, but they were actually selling samosas and popcorn and soft drinks, which is where they were getting their money from. And at the end of the story, I said, Shah Rukh, it doesn't matter how good your performance is or how bad your performance is, because I don't know what is good and what is bad. It has to be a profitable performance. Are you getting it? I mean, there are some fabulous actors who give us fabulous performances and fabulous films, and those films just don't work. And sometimes there are terrible actors, I won't mention names, and their films do 400 crore rupees at the box office. But 400 crores at the box office means 4,000 theaters playing 5 shows a day. Calculate how much popcorn is being sold, calculate how much samosa is being sold, and understand the rule one of this talk. You have to know your real profession. Half the country loved Shah Rukh in Devdas. Half the country may have hated Shah Rukh in Devdas. I don't know whether it's a good performance, because good is a subjective word. Who defines what good is? And if you cannot translate that subjective into an objective word, you cannot gauge, you cannot create a formula, you cannot create a template. So understand your real profession, your real career, and to do that, you have to first move with your facts. If I ask any of you, where does the sun rise? You'll say it rises in the east, and you'd be right. Where does the sun set? It sets in the west. You're right. But you can't create a formula, because it doesn't rise, it doesn't set, it stays in one place. We go round and round. So if you try to base your template on that truth, it won't work. You have to translate into fact. So I turn around and say the balance sheet of Devdas is 75 crore rupees. It's profitable. So we know he's a star. So we know he will continuously get employed. And that's the process that keeps on changing in this world. So we come to the next point. All of you are looking at some sort of careers now. Understand what's going to be obsolete in 5 years. Understand what's not going to be working in the next 5 years. As the world gets automated, computerized, robotized, a lot of the jobs are going to get computerized, automated, and robotized. You have to be in careers that are going to be computer-proof. And those are careers which are creative. The computers and the automation cannot take away your imagination, cannot take away your skills, cannot take away your talent, cannot take away the creativity that each one of you has in you. You have to understand that what is not takeawayable is what is going to give you not just a career, but a stable, sustainable, scalable, profitable, lucrative, remunerative career. So you have to go inside yourself and figure out, I want to do this. I don't know whether I should because mommy, daddy don't like it. I don't know whether I should because nobody else has gone into this from people whom I know. I don't know whether I should do this, but actually do. Look at what you like. Look at what you're interested in. That's what Shah Rukh did. He became a businessman. He understood it was not about performances. It was about selling territories, which had to sell tickets, which had to sell thumbs up, which had to tell. He realized it and he talks about it. He says the more stakeholders that happen on a film that I make, the less risk there is. If I make a film costing 100 rupees and there's one stakeholder, he can lose 100 rupees. But if there are 100 stakeholders, that's 1 rupee each. If there's 1,000 stakeholders, it's 10 naya paisa each. So the aim of being a star, as opposed to being an actor, is to start creating shareholders in the success of a project. Remember, whatever it is that got you wherever you are is not good enough to keep you there. Remember that every single thing that you spend money on is a hobby. Everything that earns money for you is a profession. And also understand that these are the 3 golden rules I gave Shah Rukh. They're all in his TED talk. So I'll repeat them. Everything that got you wherever you are or wherever you are now is not good enough to keep you there tomorrow. 2, anything that means spending money is a hobby. It's when you earn it that it becomes a profession. And the 3rd and the biggest golden rule, And I told him this in the context of the film industry, but I'm telling you this in the context of life. Anything, but this is really very important, this is the most important rule. There's a lot of place here for newcomers. All of us, when we go into industry, will be newcomers. There's ample space. I was a newcomer, I've made 40 films with 40 new directors. Shah Rukh was a newcomer, he came from Delhi to Bombay, he lived in a place called Gautam Nagar, didn't know anything. But we were newcomers, and there's a lot of place for us. There's no place for amateurs. Understand the difference. I love movies, Shah Rukh loves movies, we watch movies, there's a knowledge. We don't have experience because we're new. We're newcomers, but we know. An amateur is someone who fakes it, who doesn't know, who doesn't understand what his job is, but pretends he does. We are very scared of them. When a child comes to me and says, I'm really, seriously, sir, I'm very talented. I didn't ask you to be talented. Let me understand how much you know, and let me understand how your passion is actually translated into knowledge, and they don't. I can send them to Aditya Chopra or Shah Rukh Khan by picking up the phone. But though they say they love Shah Rukh and they have passion for the industry, they cannot tell us who Shah Rukh's first film is. They cannot tell us in which year his biggest hits were. There's no knowledge. So your talent, your skill, your creativity will translate into a career, avoid you being obsolete, provided it is matched by qualifications. And that's why you're in some of the best schools, the best school here. And it is all about knowledge. And I had to tell him that Google will give you a lot of information. Translating that information into knowledge is what your teacher does for you, what your guides do for you, what your mentors do for you. And then translating that knowledge into wisdom is when you and your mentors sit together and talk it through. Every one of my students, I am accessible 24 hours a day. And I guarantee you all, every single one of your teachers will be accessible to you 24 hours a day because they're not just your teachers, they're your mentors. Teachers are a very special breed of people. They can't teach you if they don't love you. Today I tell you, standing here on this stage, your teachers love you. You pick up the phone and you call, they will be ready, available for you continuously 24 hours of the day. I've seen it. That's why they're teachers. That's why they've chosen to teach instead of doing anything else. So remember these words, and it's these principles on which Shah Rukh has actually built the foundation for his success, because success is not something that anybody teaches.